I'm Umi Leila and I'm representing HomeNet Pakistan. On this auspicious occasion, I'm very delighted to be here as part of this media campaign. I just want to reiterate that home-based workers all over the world, and specifically in Pakistan also, the women who are representing the informal economy are facing different kinds of violence. And it's not that today that this has come up. It has been there since the work for home-based workers or for the women informal economy started. So the women are facing different kinds of violence, whether it's economic violence, whether it's physical violence, it's emotional, psychological violence. It's always been there. And we have seen that empowerment of women in the context of women in the home-based workers as a major part of the informal economy. Their economic empowerment is hampered if they face these psychological and social taboos with regard to the violence that is inflicted on them, and specifically the economic violence that they face throughout their career. So I'm very glad that we have finally have this convention, ILO Convention 190 against violence and harassment in the world of work. It is very important to recognize the importance of work culture based on mutual respect and community of human being to prevent violence and harassment. And recognizing that violence and harassment in the world of work is a major violation of human rights and its abuse. And the violence and harassment is a threat to equal opportunities, which is unacceptable and incompatible for the decent world. And the ILO Convention 190, Violence and Harassment in the World of Work, deprives, talks about the deprivation of the people. And it talks about the dignity, and it says that it is incompatible with decent work and is a threat to the equal opportunities, safe, healthy, and productive working environment. And it remains a widespread phenomenon, which is present in all countries, disregarding the sectors, occupations, and work arrangements. But in countries like Pakistan and in countries like South Asia, this violence ratio is very high. And I think with the adoption of the Convention 190 and the Recommendation 206, which recognizes the right of everyone in a world of work free from violence and harassment, including gender-based violence and harassment, we call for taking action, ratification of the convention, and implementation of the convention in full spirit by changing the existing law, bringing in amendments, developing the frameworks, and creating awareness among the workers in the informal economy so that they can take up the issue of violence and reach out to the opportunities that are existing within the government department, and they can address their issues accordingly.